Hey guys, happy Friday. We just got done doing this yard here. I put up a tune-up video for the Echo SRM225 weed eater, the curb find. So we did a tune-up on that little machine there. Worked like a champ. You could check out how to do it, the part number that I used and all that, you know, the tune-up kit, where to get it, how to install it, and the results. And it was fantastic. And while we were doing this yard, we got stopped by the original HOA violator. I'll link to that video series up here if you're new to my channel. That was Sarah, and that was a five-part video series. And Sarah has since moved away, long time ago. And here we have the new residents. And it doesn't look like things are much better. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this yard up. And they did hire me for every 2 weeks. From this point on, yes, they are paying me a little bit extra. Yes, they know that I do YouTube videos, so we're not going to discuss price or anything like that. I did let her know that I would be filming. But let me say something to you guys real quick here in all honesty. Please keep the comments to yourself picking on people, all right? You don't know their situation. You don't know what they're going through. You don't know why the yard's like this. And frankly, nobody gives a shit what you think when it comes to other people. All right, watch the videos to learn things, to see progress made, to be inspired to go out and clean up your own yard, to side hustle, to make money, to get off food stamps, to get off Medicaid, to do things for yourself. If you're here to poke fun at people or to talk about how nasty somebody is or the inside of their house must be even worse, get off the channel because nobody cares. So if you comment like that, I'm just going to delete it and I'm going to block you. And if you're a long-time friend subscriber, it doesn't matter. When you do stuff like that, you hurt all of us from being able to share what we do, because then we have to think twice before we do something on video for people. This is a learning experience, and this is a channel that teaches, okay? We don't go around picking on people, and we don't go around talking shit. All right, enough said about that. So the first thing we're going to do with this nasty-ass freaking yard, I can't believe this. I'm just kidding. The first thing we're going to do, we're going to edge this up. We're going to get it cleaned up. We're going to get it ready to mow. We're going to do the whole front because I then have to go get my kids and we're going to take it from there. All right. So this is the original HOA violator returns. All right. So when it comes to doing these edges, the biggest thing about it is just get to it. All right. Just tackle them. So what I'm going to do, you're going to see me coming forward, go backwards. You might see me go forward again, turn around and go forwards, backwards. Just gotta do it.
Thank you.
right, now the next thing you know that I like to do, after I edge a mess, is I go with the weed eater, I clean up the edges, and then I'll blow it all in. All right, for this, we're gonna use my more powerful weed eater, the Steel FS100 RX 4-Mix. And we edged with the KM90 combi system with the straight edger attachment. Let's go ahead and clean up. Cartridges spooled up, ready to go. 5 or 6 arm lengths. The speed feed on the Echo, the one that I have, the speed feed, only holds like 3 arm lengths. And it's kind of inefficient for me. So these, I just keep them ready to go and I just swap them out. Having a tough time with the camera right now, man. It's hot as balls. We discussed hot balls in yesterday's video. I want to check that out. Goal for what we're doing, we edged nasty yard. We're gonna weed eat it in, then we're gonna blow it all in and have it prepped for mowing. So the mower can do all of the cleanup. right, before I waste too much time with the blower, I'm just going to run with the rake real fast and get some of the bulk stuff up and then see if we need to blow it off. Might not need to. Let me show you guys what it looks like with just being edged and weed-eated. And again, I have to apologize. This camera is just overheating so bad. There's no shade anywhere, so I'm doing the best I can to give you guys full shots. But this is what it looks like, edged, weed-eated, and cleaned up, blown in, ready to mow. I mean, it makes a big difference when you can get it to this point. So let me go ahead and set you guys up, and I'm going to try to help you guys. I'll try to keep checking the camera.
right now.
Got you guys in the shade, pretty okay. Little light pole right here, actually, and the camera's in the shade. I just changed the battery, I chopped it down, so now we're gonna go over it and try to make it look nice. That little mess. Now if that was nice mulch, nice stuff there, of course I wouldn't do that, but there's nothing there, so who cares. I'll blow it out with the blower, and hey, maybe a little ground cover won't hurt. Now we got to do this mess. You're in the direct sun, so I don't know how long this is gonna last, but I'll try. Thank you. Hey, it's my customer. I'll blow that off. Don't worry. I won't leave it. But here you go. We are cut. We are edged. We are weed eated. Trimmed. Whatever. And we're at 3 inches, just like the neighbor. I chopped it down, guys. Would have been a lot easier if I cut it at 4 inches. I wasn't looking for ease. I'm looking to make it so in 2 weeks, I come back here, I get right through it like a normal yard. Okay, I'm gonna take a brief intermission so I can go get my kids. And then I'll be back to do the backyard. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and start the backyard now. It's 7:26. So we'll start the backyard, but before we do the first weed eat, we're gonna trim mow everything. So we're gonna run down here with the mower, just so I can see what I'm weed eating a little bit better and get things picked up. This way here, when I weed eat, I can see what I'm weed eating. It'll help the weed eater. And also we're gonna use the Echo. cutting it at 3 inches, and I'm weed eating it at that height as well. So we're gonna do it at 3 inches. We're cutting it and we're weed eating it to the height I want it. A little bit harder right now. I could get away with raising the deck and weed eating higher, but I want it at 3 inches now, today. And in 2 weeks when I come back, then it'll be a breeze. So just working it, man, working it. This weed eater doesn't have a lot of power. So things like this, holding up the head, I notice it. It has a little bit of hard time getting through it. And look, I mean, this is, you know, a residential style weed eater here. This isn't a commercial heavy duty weed eater. So I'm not, certainly not knocking. 15, so we've been at it for almost an hour. Whatever. I mean, we're filming too. Today was to get the job done at a fair price, get her set up for the next 2 weeks, get it cut again, and it'll be nice. So yeah, we did some shortcuts today. Yeah, there's other ways it could have been done, but it also could have been done 3 months ago too. So it is done. You got a dog in the house that can come out and play now. That looks pretty all right. I'll blow this out on my way out. Let's go take a look at the front one last time. So you remember what this looked like about an hour ago? Now it's done. Can't complain. The job is complete. When I did this yard the first time for Sarah, back in 2016 probably, the yard was mushy, real mushy, and I couldn't use my zero turn. Today, the yard's real mushy, and going over it a couple times like I did in the front, especially up there, was real mushy, and in the back on the other side of that fence was real mushy. Again, the walk behind made it possible. There you go. She is finished, she is legal, she is happy, she is paid. And also, my favorite customers right here, they are an awesome group. Paid with a tip, and they pay in advance. So I was like, that's not what you have to give me. Did you give me a tip? She's like, no, we gave you what we wanted to give you. And I was like, okay, thank you very much. So awesome couple. We're gonna lose them in September. They're moving, so that sucks. I think maybe the end of September. So that kind of sucks, but so that's it. Guys, HOA violator, once again, tamed. I'll see you guys on the next one.
Tell me about the whistle. The whistle.